Hey, what's going on everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys how we can create a sliding scale in Python. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Let's create a scale. So we'll need a window. Window equals TK, followed by window.mainLoop. We'll create a scale called scale. Scale equals scale. We need to add the scale to our window, so we'll put that here. We can list a from position and a to position. Both of these values will be our range of values that we can use for our scale. So from, make sure to add an underscore after from. It won't work without this underscore. From equals, let's say 0, and to equals 100. So we're going to create a scale for temperature. And this will be in Celsius. So 0 will be freezing and 100 will be the boiling point, for water. So then to display the scale, we'll need to add scale.pack. And let's run this. So the from position is 0. So that's at the top here. And then if you go down, it increases. So you can actually flip this. So we'll say from 100 and 2 will be 0. So now you can scroll up and the number will increase. Let's also get the current value. So we'll need a button. So button equals button. We'll add this to the window. We'll add some text. Text equals submit. And then a command. Command equals submit, but we'll have to make this function. So let's do that outside the window. Def submit. And we will simply print the current temperature. So let's display a message. The temperature is plus scale.get plus degrees Celsius. We can just say degrees C. So let's try this, but we also have to pack the button. So button.pack. So if we were to try and submit this, right now scale.get is going to return an integer, so we need to convert this to a string. So str scale.get, and you have to do that with Python if you're displaying a integer value along with another string. You need to convert it to a string. So now this should work. So it is 82 degrees Celsius. So let's do some cosmetic changes for our temperature gauge, because right now it's kind of ugly. So the first thing we'll change is, let's say the length. So length equals 600. So that should be fairly large. You can also set the orientation. So that is orient, spelt like that. So this can either be vertical, which it currently is, or horizontal. But I'll keep this as vertical. So I'll add a comment that this is orientation of scale. Let's also change the font. So font equals, pick whatever font you want, and a size, so maybe 20. Now you can add some tick intervals. Maybe I'll set this to 10. So these will be numeric indicators on the scale. And show value. This hides the current value. So if you set this to 0, this will hide current value. So it no longer displays what the current value is next to the slider. To actually retrieve it, you'd have to get the value. So right now it's 40, but it helps that you have the tick intervals on the left-hand side. I should probably add that this adds numeric indicators for value. Good enough. Let's continue on. Now let's use the set function. We can set the current value of the knob on our scale, and by default it is 0. So we can use the scale.set function, and we can place a number in here, a value. So let's say we want this to be 100. So this is now at the 100 position instead of 0. If we wanted this in the middle, we could set this to 50. And now it's in the middle. However, if you change the range of your scale of from -2 and set this to 50, and now 50 is all the way down here, so it no longer appears in the middle. So this isn't really necessary, but if you want this to be a little more sophisticated, there's actually a formula that you could use. We can use scale, straight braces, and then place the word from within here. This will give us our max, basically. So this is from without an underscore. So this, not this, this. Scale from minus scale 2. And then we're going to divide this by 2. And then I'm just going to put this within a extra set of parentheses. Plus scale 2. Just in case our 2 value is greater than 0. We just want to account for that. And then I'm just going to put these within another set of parentheses. So this should always appear in the middle then, even if we were to change this range. Yeah, it seems like it works. Like I said, it's not really necessary, but if you want this to be a little more sophisticated, that would work. Now let's make some cosmetic changes to this scale and make it look pretty. So first, let's change the trough color. This is this gray portion right here. So let's set the trough color equals whatever color you want. You could say like blue, or you can place a hex value here. And I actually picked one out already. So I'm going to use 69EAFF. And that is this icy blue color, kind of like this is sliding on ice. And I'm also going to change the font color. And I'm going to pick this fiery red color to symbolize heat. And then you can change the background color too. So that is BG. And I'll just set this to like black. It's looking kind of cool now, right? And for no good reason, I'm gonna add some pictures. So feel free to pause the video if you'd like to download some images. I'm going to use an image of a flame for the hot side of our scale and a snowflake for the cold side. So let's begin by adding the hot image to the scale before we actually add the scale to the window. So we'll do this after we instantiate the window because that's the only place that we can do that. So we're going to create a image. I'll just call this hot image for the fire icon. So hot image equals photo image file equals, this is hot.png. So hot.png. We're going to add the image to a label. I'll call this hot label. Hot label label image equals hot image. And then we need to pack this. So hot label.pack. And this should appear at the top. Let's test it. Yep, there it is. Let's do the same thing for the cold side. So I'll add this here before the button. And I'm going to replace hot with cold. Same thing with the file name, cold.png. This will be cold label, cold image, and cold label.pack. And that should be it. Let's take a look. Not too shabby. It's looking pretty sweet. It has our submit button at the bottom too. So right now the temperature is 100 degrees Celsius. The temperature is 0 degrees Celsius. The temperature is 60 degrees Celsius. Well, that's how to create a scale in Python. If you would like a copy of all this code, I'll post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's how to create a scale in Python. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.